So inshallah ta'ala, in a few days, we will all be praying Taraweeh inshallah. May Allah keep us alive to witness the month of Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan, ya Rabbil Alameen. And as we all know, we want to take advantage of every single moment in Ramadan. We want to utilize literally every moment. There are so many brothers and sisters that are dear to many of us, and they were with us last year, but they did not make it to this Ramadan. So if Allah keeps me alive to witness this month of Ramadan, wallahi, that by itself is a gift from Allah Azza wa Jal. Because He is giving me and you an opportunity for this neck to be saved from the hellfire, for all our sins to be forgiven. So just by itself to witness Ramadan, that's a choice by Allah Azza wa Jal. Millions of people are fasting, millions of people are praying Taraweeh, millions of people are reading the Quran, but here the people of EPIC are going to be different. Because tonight we're going to learn three du'as that we will be reciting every single night in Ramadan. Every night. The first du'a. Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, every night, it's a long hadith, and at the end of the hadith, he said, وَلِكُلْ وَفِي لَيْلَةِ وَلِلَّهِ عُتَقَاء فِي كُلِّ لَيْلَةِ. And Allah decrees certain amount of people for their neck to be saved from the hellfire, and that is every single night in Ramadan. Let me ask you a question before we learn the dua. When we say that this person is saved from the hellfire, what does that mean? It means he was going to the hellfire and Allah saved him. May Allah save us all. Which is the first dua. Rabbana a'tiq riqabana minan nar. Every single night in Ramadan. Don't wait for the last 10 nights. Every night, as a matter of fact, every sajda. Ya Allah, I want my name to be on that list. Because of the name listed this year, from this year till the year you die, khalas, you will become righteous. You will act and do and behave of the people, the a'mal of the people of Jannah. Because you are already decreed. Allah, astaghfirullah, does not change His mind next year. That's it. You are decreed on 2024 that you are from the people who are saved from the hellfire. You khalas, you're saved from the hellfire. You will start doing the a'mal of the people of Jannah. Remember what we said last time? When we are in Jannah, Ya Rabbi, may Allah, just like He gathered us here, gather us in the Firdaus al-A'la. We were sitting in Jannah, and then we see each other because, you know, we love each other. I love Samir so much. I'm going to look for him in Jannah. And I'm going to see him and say, Samir, what was the reason for you to enter Jannah? Because everybody knows, what was that amal? What year was it decreed? Oh, it was 2024 Ramadan. My name was written on the list. It was 1996. It was, you know, 1781. Everybody knows what was the amal and what was the year that he entered Jannah. So inshallah, we beg Allah to make this year the year that our name is on that list. So the first dua, Rabbana a'tiq alif ayn ta qaf riqabana minan nar. Rabbana a'tiq riqabana minan nar. Five words, right? Rabbana a'tiq riqabana minan nar. Five words. Second dua, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whomsoever witness Laylatul Qadr, all his previous sins are forgiven. We all know the dua, and we all know the virtues of Laylatul Qadr, khayrun min alfi shahr. We all beg Allah Azza wa Jal to witness it. So my second dua, Allahumma balighni Laylatul Qadr. From day one, don't wait till the last 10 nights and beg. This is what everybody does, but not us. We will be asking Allah from the first night, Allahumma balighni Laylat al-Qadr. Four words. Ya Allah, I'm so serious, Ya Allah. I'm not waiting for the last 10 nights. From now, I'm begging you, Ya Allah, please make me from the people who witness Laylatul Qadr. Third, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهِ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah only, إِنَّمَا أَدَاتْ حَصْر, exclusively. Allah only accepts from the muttaqeen, from the righteous, from the pious. May Allah make us from the muttaqeen. Ali radiallahu an, he said, you should be more concerned about the acceptance of the amal than the amal itself. So we are fasting every day. We are reading Quran. We are making dua. We are giving donation. We are praying tahajjud. So what's the third dua? ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. Ya Allah, accept all the stuff that I'm doing. Ya Allah, please, I know I'm behind. I know it's not much, but please, Ya Allah, I beg you, accept. Right? We should be concerned about the acceptance. We, alhamdulillah, we will all be doing a lot of great deeds, but also we want to beg Allah Azza wa Jal to accept. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. Who said this dua? Which prophet? Ibrahim alayhi salam. When he was doing what? Building the Kaaba. Is there anything more noble than building the Kaaba? Yani you, when you build the Kaaba, you would say, خلاص, this is 100% accepted. I'm building the Kaaba. Millions of people are coming to perform Hajj. Even that, he begged Allah to accept. What about building a small amal in this dunya? So we have to beg Allah. So what are the three du'as? ربنا أعتق رقابنا من النار. اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. Three du'a every single night in Ramadan. Finally. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that hadith we all know. But when I make dua for you in your absence, Allah will assign an angel to say, Ameen. وَلَكَ بِالْمِثْلِ. And you got the same thing. You got the same thing you ask for your brother. Ya Allah, guide my brother. May Allah guide you too. Ameen, and may Allah guide you too. Ya Allah, cure my sister. Ameen. An angel. You know, when someone goes to Hajj, we beg them to make dua for us because they will be clean. That cleanliness, I don't know how long it's going to last, but this angel, 100% is clean. لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم. They never disobey Allah, and he's saying Ameen to my dua. So, please, I beg you, don't forget our brothers and sisters in Gaza through the whole month. In Yemen, in Syria, in Lebanon, in Bangladesh, in Kashmir, in Sudan, in Sin, everywhere. Make dua for our brothers and sisters so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so the angel will say Ameen. And if we ever are going through this one day in this life, inshallah, we will get people also to make dua for us. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. And if you can, please throw one dua for me and my family. I would really appreciate that. Jazakum Allah khair.
شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون.